Hey everybody, Pat Foster here, Tallon, Lafontaine. We're out at Fox Raceway today for the 2025 intro of the KTM 250 SXF. This is our first impression video brought to you by our friends at Garnet. Tallon, this is a fun day. I spent a little bit of time on the factory edition bike. You spent a little time on it. This is basically the factory edition from a few months ago without some of the bells and whistles, some of the anodized parts.
Yeah.
The big news is the new frame, new chassis. Last year's chassis, a lot of people complained that it was too firm, too rigid. Personally, I liked it. I didn't mind it. I did notice it was a little bit firm on lean-in and acceleration chop coming out, but I was excited to get on this thing again because, you know, it's been a little while. What did you think of the bike today? First things that stand out to you?
I think the word that comes to mind is just smooth. It just feels really smooth. I feel like I can kind of go anywhere I want on the track, and it doesn't do anything crazy at all. I was just kind of going over everything in my head, going over my laps, and I'm like, man, this thing, I can put it anywhere and feel comfortable. So I think smooth is like the best way to describe this chassis.
You looked good on it. And when you came in, you told me, you're like, wow, man, I feel really good on this thing. It feels like I can push it hard. It feels like I can do whatever I want with it. And it looked like you could. You're ripping on it.
Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah. So speaking of the new chassis and being able to ride it aggressively, I notice a big difference with this chassis. It's a lot more compliant, it's a lot more forgiving. The bike feels better connected to the track surface, and it just feels like coming into corners, you can attack better. Leaning in, you can trust it a little bit more. I had a lot of trust in the front end. We've talked about it a lot over the years. The air fork, it continues to get better and better and better, and this is great. I haven't always trusted the front end as much as other brands, but man, I felt good on it today. I felt like I could really trust it. And I think that this chassis works really well with this front end to where you can go in aggressively, carve into the corner, know that it's gonna stick, it's gonna be predictable. The other place that I noticed a little bit of an issue with the chassis last year was exiting corners. As you're coming out and it's a little choppy, you'd wanna skate and maybe not be as connected. This felt really well connected to the track. What did you think in those areas?
I agree 100%. There's a couple spots where the fork felt like it might have been just floating a tad, and it was kind of like in the middle or the exit of the corner. Felt pretty good under braking, but like when the weight would transfer to the rear, I would feel it kind of like floating, I guess, a little bit, but it didn't feel uncomfortable or anything. It just felt like that was like the characteristic of it. And then, like you were saying, coming out of the corners, that chop in the rear, I didn't really get much of that. I felt like it just drove out of the corners really nice. I was trying to cut out of a couple corners that got blown out.
Yep.
And it felt like I didn't even have to try that hard to get it to cut out and drive. It was just, it just did it. So I didn't spend much time on the old model, but this model 250 just seems really compliant, really comfortable. Like you said, confident. I felt really confident, and I could kind of just manhandle the thing, which was cool. Like I didn't feel uncomfortable anywhere.
Good.
I hate to sound like this is the best bike ever, but I'm being honest. Like nothing really caught me off guard. There's nothing that came up on the bike where I was like, whoa, I didn't like that. Everywhere it was pretty good. I'd say if I had one complaint, it would be on the engine side of things. If I was in the wrong gear entering a corner and I didn't shift down, or I like to ride at a gear high normally, you have to be in the right gear because it's not going to pull that that low end RPM very well. So that'd be kind of the only thing.
So it was a little sluggish down low for you?
Exactly.
Do you think it was you?
Me? I have put on a few pounds, is that what you're trying to say?
I just say, I don't know, you're not racing all the time anymore. Yeah. Maybe you're a little, we could work on your cornering or something. Maybe I can help you carry a little more speed through. No, I did notice what you noticed. It's the power delivery down low feels pretty broad and smooth, and it is easy to manage. And some of the things that you mentioned earlier as attributes, like you can manhandle it, you can be aggressive.
Yeah.
I think the power delivery allows you to do that, right?
Exactly.
Because it's smooth, because it's not going to get away from you, it's like you can give it as much as you want. But if you don't hit everything perfect, or you happen to be in a little bit high of a gear, it does have a tendency to want to fall on its face a little bit.
Yeah.
So you either got to make sure you downshift to second to click third, or if you're going to carry third, you got to nail it, right? You got to hit all your marks perfectly.
100%.
But I felt that too, and I did feel it kind of fall on its face a little bit. Have to stab the clutch a little here and there.
Yeah.
However, once you got into third and you got into the RPMs, this engine's a monster, right? It pulls so far in each gear. You can rev it as long as you want, and tons and tons of top end on this bike.
Right. And it rolls really good. Rolls super free. Like you said, once you get out of second into third and you start picking up momentum, like coming out of second, I feel like I'm on a horse just whipping it, trying to get it going. And then once it's up there, it's good and it rolls really free. It's just keeping that momentum up, yep. I feel like is important on this bike, and the chassis allows you to do that. So I think it's a kind of a give and a take.
Yeah, I agree. One of the other things I wanted to mention about this bike that I really like is they've got some extra bodywork pieces. You can see, you know, down on the frame, they've added some contact areas for your boots. And that's one thing I really like about these Garnet boots, by the way. Really good traction on the inside to grip the bike. And then the KTM really offers a lot of contact points to hold onto the bike. So it really makes it a lot easier. I like standing up on the bike going into corners. And I typically stand up late. And it's just really easy to control the bike with your feet rather than holding on with your hands. And I really appreciate KTM's efforts. A lot of these things are textured. It's got good grip on it. And I think a lot of cool attention to detail on this bike.
Yeah, I agree with that. And one thing, I think everybody always talks about the brakes on the KTM. Mm-hmm. I haven't ridden a KTM in a while, and that was another thing. It's just, they're so plush and smooth, and it's just another great feature on these bikes.
Really strong, but a progressive feel.
Exactly.
Right? They're not grabby.
Right.
They're just smooth and strong. So, ergonomically, the bike feels great. Feels fast. It's comfortable. You got anything else we want to add?
Honestly, not really. It was, like I said, the word that comes to mind is smooth, and I felt smooth on the bike. The bike just felt like it was kind of gliding around. Even when you'd hit some of those bigger bumps, it felt like it handled them nice. Nothing really bad to say, or nothing that stands out too much.
And you put the bike upside down a couple of times. I'm sure Chase has already shown it in the video, but Chase, show it again because it was gnarly. And anyways, guys, so yeah, not a lot of changes to the KTM, but a lot of focus change on just the things that they need to. One other difference that I'll talk about between this bike and the factory edition is you can buy for about $250 the front fender that's got the GPS, and you can adjust the amount of engine braking in the bike, you can adjust the power. So all of the phone connectivity, you can buy the front fender, and you could have all of those things with this bike, just like you have with the factory edition. So guys, thank you very much for tuning in. Thank you to Garnet for allowing us to do this, and look forward to the 250 shootout.